The shiur is dedicated to Zecher Nishmas Rechaleya Bas Rav Chaim Tzvi. We are going to be studying now Kina, which in the list of Kinos is called Kina number Zayin. Echa Atzta V'Apecha Le'abe B'Ad Adomim Emunecha. The Kina is also written by Rav Elazar Kalir. We mentioned last time he's one of the most popular of all the Paitonim, according to some Rishonim. He may even be one of the Tanoim. The Balei HaTos discuss whom he was. But Rav Elazar Kalir was an astounding poet and astounding Paiton. Someone who was able to weave so artfully together Mamari Chazal, Psukim Tanakh, Midrashim, and an incredibly eloquent poetic style. One that absolutely is grandiloquent beyond belief. Here, in Mizmor, Kina Zayin rather, that begins Eicha Atzta V'Apecha, you'll notice in the sheets in front of you, and also in the commentary of the art scroll directed below, you notice the first 11 stanzas are constructed in the following manner. And he describes it to you, and obviously here what you have is the Aleph Beis. You'll notice that in the first paragraph that begins Eicha Atzta V'Apecha, notice that the Alephs are highlighted. And the second line, the bases are highlighted. And this is the pattern that essentially Rav Elazar Kalir follows the entire Kina. The first paragraph has in it the Aleph Beis. The second paragraph has in it Gimel and Dalet. As you can see, the Gimel highlighted in the first sentence, Eicha Ga'arta Bigarasecha Liglos Biadgeim Geulecha. And the fourth line, or the second line of the second stanza, V'lozacharta ligas diluk derech asher dalakta lid golecha. And then we continue along a similar pattern. In stanza number three, we have the language of Eicha hakta behegyonecha lahadof biyad holim hamonecha. Notice the use of the hay. The following sentence, V'lozacharta viud Vesek, Veset, Asher Viadato Libu Decha. Again, the use of the Vav. And we continue. Eicha Zanachta is the Zayin. The sentence following, Vazacharta, Chitun Chuke Chorev, Asher Chalkakta Lachamulecha is the Ches. We continue with the Tes and the Yud. And Eicha Tarachta Bitarchecha. And Vazacharta, Yikar Yedidis Yoshe, that's the Yud. The stanza following is the Chaf and Lamed. Kivanta b'chasecha, again the Chaf is highlighted, and the Lamed as well. Ulo zacharta, ulo l'znach le'olam, asher nimanta l'idkuchecha. And continuing on the next page, you have also the Mem and the Nun. Eicha milalta b'mo'asecha, ulo zacharta n'siyas notzas nesher. Eicha sachta b'sa'adecha, that's the use of the, as one can see, the sin. And often the sin and the samach undergo metathesis, so even though you have the sin found in the first sentence, Eicha sachta b'sa'arecha, but the sin and the samach, as I said, are also yas mischalfos. B'lo zacharta oz adi adoyim asher yitadu l'avadecha, the use of the ayin. The next paragraph is the pei and the tzadik. Eicha patzta b'fachdecha, and lefagir biaparit simply echav lazacharta the tzadik talas fi tzadik, and finally the kuf and the resh and the shin and the tuf, and the end of course is the language of the last paragraph. Ta'aninu, we have grown lishbok dmos kamayim al mebiyom zen nishvinu pamayim, while we were taken captive twice. Zachri bios bishalva yosheves v'yushalayim, I remember how I dwelt b'menucha in Yerushalayim. Raganiti, I complained. Ve'ata ade adchuk shamayim, which begins the next kina. So we have here the use of the Aleph Beis. In general, we pointed out already a number of times in our shiurim that the use of the Aleph Beis essentially is the following. It's not possible really for any finite human being, and a Jew is included as well in the category of finite human beings, to either say Shvachim to Hashem Yisbarach in a proper way, and to exhaust our ability to say Shvachim to Hashem Yisbarach in a similar fashion. Here we are lamenting, we're involved in a dirge, and generally the most practical way of doing it is through the use of the aleph beis. So that's one simple explanation of the aleph beis. Meidach Gisa, I heard from my Rebbe Rav Soloveitchik Zochem the Bracha a number of times that since we are limited in terms of our ability to express ourselves, therefore we in fact say to Hashem Yisbarach, here we are presenting you with the aleph beis. More or less we have utilized whatever human limitations have been given to us, and now the rest is up to you. Hashem Yisbarach, we've done our part, and now obviously Hashem Yisbarach, hopefully you'll respond to our tefillos, to our bakashas, to our kinos, and Beis Hashem Yisbarach, once again, we'll be able to restore the intimate relationship that we once had with you. That's the use of the aleph beis that you find quite often in piyutim and in kinos.